Hey, what's up everybody? Too Tall Toby here, and today I am excited because today I made my very first assembly in Onshape. So over the next couple of videos, I'm gonna take you through my process. I'm gonna show you how you can add parts from your part studio to your assemblies and how you can get in there and start creating some basic mates so that you too can experience Onshape assembly motion.
Ow!
So we're gonna start out here in the standard Onshape part studio environment. In this model, I went through and created a simple two-piece assembly. I've got a lid and a base for a box, and you can see that there's a hinge here. I'm gonna need to create a pin that runs through this hinge, and I'll do that in just a moment. But I wanted to call to your attention that whenever you get into an Onshape document, you're gonna have these tabs down at the bottom. One tab for your part studio, which starts out empty, but eventually you will populate it with geometry, and one for assembly, which also starts out empty. Now, this part studio actually contains two different parts. So I've got the box lid and I've got the main box, and they were designed together, which is very convenient because I can create references to geometry that should align, like the top and the bottom of the lid should be the same size, and this hinge area here should all be the same size. Very convenient when you're designing it all in one window. But now what I want to do is show the lid opening and closing, and I can't really do that in this part studio. This is where I need to create an assembly in Onshape. And to create that assembly, what I do is go to this assembly tab and I choose to insert components into this assembly. Now, those components could either come from the current document, which usually makes the most sense. You design the entire project in one document using the different tabs at the bottom. Or those components could come from other documents if maybe you did a different project earlier and now you want to reuse some of those parts from that other document. But for today's example, I'm going to be bringing in these components from the existing document. Now, this box is a multi-body or a multi-part part studio. So I've got these two different parts here that we looked at a moment ago. I'm going to click on main box and I'm going to click on box lid, and then I'm going to hit the green check mark, and that drops both of those components directly on the origin. And this is now an assembly, which means that I can take one of these components and I can drag it around. I don't want to drag around the blue part because it's positioned perfectly on the origin. So I'm going to do a right mouse button on the blue part and I'm going to choose fix. That way that component is locked in place and I cannot drag it, but I can drag the green part around and get it ready to be mated into place. Now it's time to create the geometry for the pin. Now, I could go back to my part studio and just start creating the geometry for the pin here in context. That would certainly work, and honestly, that's normally how I would do it. But just to show you a bit more functionality, I'm gonna go down here to the bottom of the screen and click this plus here for insert new tab. So when I click that plus for insert new tab, you can see that there's a variety of different types of elements that we can add to this project. But what I wanna add to this project is a new part studio. So I'm gonna be creating a part studio here for the pin. I'm gonna rename this so that it's called Part Studio 1-Pin. And I'm gonna go to the top plane and begin a sketch. And I'm gonna create a sketch here that is 3 millimeters in diameter and that gets extruded up to a height of 80 millimeters. That looks good. And then I'm gonna create a little interlock here at the top of the pin. So I'm gonna create a sketch of a simple rectangle. We'll say that that rectangle is 1.5 by 5.5, and we're gonna extrude that down to a depth of 2 millimeters. And yes, I think that looks pretty good. Maybe I'll just hide these planes and change the appearance of this pin, make it kind of like a silver, and I think we're good here. So now I'm gonna go back to my assembly, and I'm once again gonna choose insert. And when I choose insert, now you see that there's an additional component here, this Part Studio 1 pin. So I'll click on that Part Studio 1 pin, I'll hit the green check mark, and once again, I can drag and drop this around on the screen. I can also click on that pin and then use these little manipulators here to change its angle of rotation or to change its position here by grabbing this arrow and dragging it over. So that's a good quick way to get your parts kind of set up for mating, but I think we're gonna save the mates for the next video. Let me know what you thought about this video down in the comments. Do you have any follow-up questions, any concerns, or do you see me doing anything that I could maybe do a little bit better? Let me know down below. And of course, if you're enjoying this video series, be sure to like and be sure to subscribe and be sure to come back for the next episode where we show how we can mate these components together in an Onshape assembly.